Good afternoon, dear friends, and welcome back to the beautiful shoreline and charming towns of Connecticut. Here we are in the town of West Haven, Connecticut, a very short commute from New York City, approximately 66 miles, and a stop on the Metro North Railroad. And it also happens to be my hometown, where I grew up and lived for many years and went to school here. And I think West Haven is a bit underrated in many, many ways. Known for its beautiful beaches and shoreline and the historic area of Savin Rock, which we're going to see later, but really there is tremendous history here. This beautiful town green, again, very, very symbolic of a typical New England village town with the open green where people congregated. The Congregational Church behind me, which dominates the green and the town during the 1700s and 1800s. There's another church behind it, the Christ Church, Episcopalian Church, and a war cemetery as well. On the green, if you could look in the background, is a bandstand where the community would come together, have a live band, concerts, art fairs over the years. When I was growing up, they would flood part of the lawn of the green and have an ice skating rink. So West Haven has a lot of surprises. The British invaded in 1779 on a rock called Savin Rock, which we're going to see later. So again, here we are, dear friends, in my hometown of West Haven, Connecticut, on the beautiful town green. Prime example of a New England village green. And we're going to explore some of the history and then the coastline of West Haven. Thank you, dear friends.
Makes me happy. Sunshine in my eyes can make me
Welcome back, dear friends, to West Haven, Connecticut. And here we are on one of the main streets of West Haven called Elm Street. And number 277 Elm Street is the oldest house in West Haven, going back to 1684, according to the records. In fact, current excavations might discover the house could be a little older and could very well be the oldest house in all of New Haven County. The house was built by Ebenezer Clark sometime during the period of 1684 to 1700, and the house was passed on over the years to various owners. The Ward family and the Heitman family, I believe, were the longest owners during the years. Therefore, the house is called officially the Ward Heitman House Museum. The last tenants and owners of the house were Dr. Nicholas Milano and family, who donated the house to the National Trust Preservation. And Dr. Milano was actually my personal family doctor growing up here as a young kid. And in those days, Dr. Milano would come with his little black satchel to your house to examine you at any given time. And when you went to the doctor's office, which was another older 19th century home right next door, you made no appointment. You didn't call in advance. You simply went there and waited in the living room with all of his beautiful original colonial furniture, with the smell of rubbing alcohol and ether throughout and the sound of opera playing in the background. And you waited for Dr. Milano to open the door when he was ready to see you. So lots of wonderful memories here, great history in West Haven. Again, the British invaded in 1779 at Savin Rock, down at the beach, which we're going to explore later. That's why I say very underrated in many, many ways. Beautiful beaches, great fish and seafood, New England cuisine, restaurants, great little trip from New York City, quick, easy, could be a wonderful weekend to combine with New Haven next door and historic Yale University. So we're going to explore a little bit more of West Haven, my hometown, and we'll see the seashore very, very soon. A beautiful view of the West Haven beaches and the shoreline leading into the harbor. So it is somewhat protected. This is Long Island Sound, and beyond in the distance is a lighthouse. And of course there are boating, fishing, several piers where one can go out with your fishing rod. And it really is very picturesque. And unexpected, I think. That's another reason why I feel that West Haven is underrated in many ways. And all along the shoreline is a beautiful promenade for walking for at least 2 miles, I believe, all the way out to another rock promontory known as Radley Rock. But then right behind me, behind the bandstand, is the Savin Rock that I mentioned. And when I was a little kid, there was a sign there that said the British invaded in 1779, so very historic as well. Beautiful New England seaside town, again, with two wonderful fish and seafood restaurants to enjoy, among many other things, right here in West Haven, Connecticut, dear friends. Thank you.
A song that I could sing for